seat right there, and I'll be right back. I'll take some of these chairs over here.
Is it Nydia?
Yes, sir.
Nydia, Mike Christian.
Hello, it's a pleasure to meet you. Your last name?
Christian.
Christian?
Yeah, water. You want some coffee or something?
No, but thank you for asking. It's her case. I do in case I can see it for you.
Is this the same address I have already on the internet report?
Yes, it is.
He made a disc and paid his picture. I'm going to nervous.
So that, I've already submitted this to evidence for us.
Same thing?
Yes.
Okay.
I just brought another copy. Okay, this is it. Have you watched it?
I have.
Okay.
It is very cut and dry.
Okay, I've already spoken with everyone except for you in this room, as far as who was on the incident report listed as possible witnesses and such. The only person that said that they saw the entire incident was Ms. Rodzinkinis. I can't even think of her name. I had it right the last time. She came in, did a full interview, was very cooperative and you know, everything went well as far as with her. She was in the video, obviously. As far as Mr. Hull, Ms. Rainey, and let's see, who am I missing? I think Ms. Fisher. They said they didn't actually see it happen, but they've seen the video since, and that was it. They knew that something had happened, they just didn't see it actually happen. So they claimed it doesn't mean that they did or didn't. Just tell me what they told me. But I did speak with all of them. Every time I spoke with somebody, it was recorded or either in here, one of the two.
Okay.
So I have all of that for you. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. So you are employed. Are you on your own business? How does all that work?
I'm self-employed.
Self-employed.
I freelance with my video camera and go to public meetings and post them online and then blog about meetings.
Do you do multiple counties or?
I have done meetings in the city of Roswell and the city of Atlanta and Fulton County and Forsyth County and in Gainesville. So I've got over 500 videos on my YouTube channel.
All right. And how long have you done this?
Approximately the last 2 years, I would say.
Okay. What gained your interest in this thing, such things?
I would attend county meetings, and I was getting verbally attacked by a commissioner. So I started carrying a tape recorder, and then that evolved into carrying a video camera and actually filming meetings when I realized that citizens have a right to film public meetings and public officials conducting public business, so I started carrying my video camera.
Okay.
And then putting it on YouTube for others to watch meetings that they were unable to attend.
Okay, so then you just developed from there then, huh?
Right.
Okay. How long have you been videoing here in Forsyth County, I guess?
Again, approximately
2 years.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything in particular that brought you to this specific event, the luncheon on the 16th?
Yes, it was advertised on the Republican Women of Forsyth County website as being this meeting is open to the public, as well as on the Forsyth County News, their community page online also read that it was the meeting was open to the public. And they said that a lot of candidates would be attending. if you wanted to meet them, it would be a great opportunity to do so because it's campaign season.
Have you attended any of the, specifically the Republican Women of Forsyth meetings or luncheons or gatherings prior to this one?
I've been to one previously.
Okay.
And I sent you an email with that detail of the date.
Mm-hmm.
And that was when Mike Dudgeon was running for office.
Okay.
And he spoke to the group. And so I went to hear him. That was at Golden Corral.
Okay.
And I happened to meet candidate Nathan Neal. He was also at that meeting, prior to becoming governor.
What's your history between you and Ms. Green? How do you guys know each other?
I don't really know her other than I saw her at that first meeting that I attended,
mm-hmm.
where Mike Dudgeon addressed voters.
Mm-hmm.
And other than that, I really have no knowledge of her.
Okay, so you guys just met in passing in the first meeting, and that's it?
Yes.
Okay. I won't really ask you a whole lot about the actual incident, because like I said, it is... Have you had any contact with her since that happened, or has she contacted you? I saw the one about, I think it was her mother that had sent you a Facebook message.
Her daughter.
Oh, her daughter. That's what I meant.
And her name is Carol Green Hathaway.
Mm-hmm.
And she sent me a private Facebook message asking me to take the video down.
Okay. And that's the only thing you've had as far as contact since then?
Correct, and I did not respond to that.
Okay.
Now, Peggy Green and I are both members of a couple different Facebook groups,
mm-hmm.
and she has posted comments on Facebook, and I have been in that thread, but not directly addressing Ms. Green. Sometimes I'll just put links to other information without really adding my own commentary.
Mm-hmm.
I think I put a quote from their website that says, we have, as citizens, we have a right to protection of our person and our property.
Mm-hmm.
And that was straight from their website, and then I put a link to the website page.
Okay.
But other than that, I've had no direct communication with Peggy Green.
Okay. All right. What about the other ladies that confronted you? Did you know them outside of anything that night?
Carolyn Hall Fisher, she was at a meeting a month previously on March 15th, Ides of March, it was a Saturday morning, mm-hmm. that I went to film, and it was the Republican Party of Forsyth County. That was at the Veteran of Foreign Wars building on Dahlonega Highway.
Mm-hmm.
And after the meeting, I walked around and introduced myself to a few people and said the video would be on YouTube if you have an interest in watching it.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, oh, I've met you before. And I actually didn't recall meeting her previously, and I couldn't remember her name. And I asked her to please refresh my memory and tell me your name.
Mm-hmm.
And so she told me her name was Carolyn Fisher.
Okay.
And that's really the only previous contact I can recall with her.
Okay.
She did get up and speak to the group that morning, and she was speaking on behalf of Jack Kingston as a candidate running for office. And I was filming her speaking at that time. And I believe I sent Jack Kingston through his campaign website an email with a link to that video.
Okay.
And I also sent a link to that video to Carolyn Fisher. I was able to find her email address online and sent her the same link.
Okay. So normally when you go to like these public events, do you do any kind of RSVP or heads up, I'm going to come, or is it okay if I have video yet or anything like that? Or is it just normally you go and there's either not an issue or there is?
Majority of the times I'll just come, especially if it's advertised as a public meeting.
Mm-hmm.
And I typically don't have any problem. People are glad to have the camera time,
mm-hmm.
Especially the candidates and the public officials, the politicians.
Mm-hmm.
And this particular day, I did not ask permission in advance. However, there was someone who was speaking to the group. Her name is Susan Zerini. She's running for school for a she very much wanted me to video record her speech.
Okay.
And that's also on the video. Mm-hmm.
When Mr. Norman approached you, what did he say to you? Did he just ask on behalf of Ms. Green, or how did he approach you with the whole thing?
I was already set up in the corner of the room, and my camera was rolling, because mm-hmm. I don't know exactly what time it's going to start, so I usually will walk in with my camera turned on just so I don't miss anything. And so I was there, and he waved me over, and I followed him, and I had not met him previously. I didn't know who he was, and he introduced himself, and he simply said, they don't want you to record.
Mm-hmm.
And I said that the guest speaker, the candidates want me to record. And about that time, Ms. Doreeny walked up and she said, well, I want her to record me. And he said, well, you all work it out.
Mm-hmm.
And then left. And he didn't identify who they were, but I presumed it was someone in the group.
Okay.
The Republican woman, of course, I can't. He didn't give me a name.
Okay.
And I didn't ask for a name. And so later in the video, when I was asking Ms. Green, she was threatening that I'll have Norman remove you from the building, and I asked her per your request, because mm-hmm. I wanted to find out who wanted that, mm-hmm. whose direction that was, and she said, she confirmed, yes, that it was her that wanted me to leave.
And so, did she want you to leave completely, or just didn't want you to record?
Both.
Okay.
She said I wasn't welcome at the meeting, and she wanted me to leave the restaurant, and she said it was a public, I'm sorry, it was a private restaurant. Well, yes, it is a privately owned restaurant, however, anyone can walk in and sit down and order a meal. It's not a club, it's not members only, where mm-hmm. you have to pay to get in or anything like that. So in that respect, it's a public restaurant.
Okay. So the initial request was not recorded all through him, and then once she confronted you, it became, we don't want you, period.
Right.
Okay.
Leave the building, leave the premises, you're not welcome here. She was very hostile.
Of course. Why do you think they didn't want you to film? What was going to happen that if you saw what her filmed, that the world would come to an end? Do you know
what
I'm asking?
That's a very good question, and I don't have an intuitive answer for that.
Mm-hmm.
A similar situation occurred 2 years previously at Cummings City Hall, mm-hmm. where the mayor of the city of Cummings did not let me film a public meeting.
Right.
And it was almost like a repeat performance of that. There seemed to be no logic. It just seemed like more of a personal vendetta against Nydia Tisdale for whatever reason. I really don't know. I just attend meetings and I want to encourage the public to be involved in the process of government and politics, and I record them and post them online for everyone to see.
Because I'll say this, and you know, I agree. It was a public meeting. I don't know of any reason for you not to be there. I can understand maybe how that would irritate some people, but again, there was not necessarily a reason, to my way of thinking, for you not to be there. And so that was just kind of a question I had, was what was going to take place that you particularly were not supposed to be privy to or whatnot, which leads me back to any history between you and Peggy. Because in watching the video, I mean, she seems, to my way of thinking, very bitter, very anti-Nydia. And I just didn't know if y'all had ever butted heads before or what was the particular reason she had for getting so upset.
I don't know her reasoning. I don't know her thought process. Mm-hmm. Although I'm aware that I can be very polarizing,
mm-hmm.
because I show public officials and show exactly what they say. Here's a video. It's irrefutable. You can't argue with it. And so it's not a misquote in an
mm-hmm.
article. And I usually show the 3-hour meeting. I show a 3-hour meeting.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be actually pretty boring at times.
Sure.
And sometimes if there's a certain portion that's of particular interest, it's 3 minutes. myself for the next certain 3 minutes. But the entire meeting is also available, and I'll usually link the two. So if you want to see all of it, you can, and here it is. And I presume that some officials don't like the coverage just because I'm showing what they're doing, and maybe they don't want the public to know what they're doing. I don't know. That's speculation.
Yeah, and it is, and I guess that's what I was asking, but I don't know. To my way of thinking here, between us, I don't understand why you should not have been there. I don't understand why this was not that big a deal. What did you do before this?
I was a property manager for a landowner in Forsyth County.
Okay.
And I was asked to attend meetings that had an impact on this person's holdings.
Okay, like zoning meetings and that sort of stuff?
Yes, there was a proposed landfill adjacent to this property, and I was asked to attend all of the zoning meetings, which I did for close to 3 years, and that's what got me interested in Forsyth County, and others who had similar issues would ask for my input after my issue was settled.
Okay. Do you have a background in journalism?
I like to write.
That's fine.
I don't have a professional background. My degree is in business management. I've always been a shutterbug. I always carry a camera.
That's fine. Let me ask you this. Why? I don't live here, so I can ask this. Property management. The chicken place. The protein place up off 306. Why have people not run them out of town yet?
I don't have knowledge.
The stench from a 10-mile radius. You know what I'm talking about?
It's probably the biggest employer in the county, or it was one of the first industries in Forsyth County, the chicken plant. And there's one right next to City Hall.
Right, but it doesn't put forth the stench like the other place.
That was part of the platform for the mayor of the city of Cumming, Mayor Graves. Was he promised to get rid of the smell in downtown Cumming at the chicken plant, and he succeeded in doing that.
Yeah. These are just things that are popping in my mind as y'all were talking. This is a personal question. It doesn't necessarily have any bearing on this. Do you get paid for doing this, or is this just donation, or...?
Actually, I have a PayPal donate button on my blog, on my website, and my videos are viewer-supported, and my blog is reader-supported. I'm not a 501c3 tax-free entity, and I tell people that.
That's great to me.
It's a gift, basically. Mm-hmm. You can't deduct it from your taxes. It's just a gift.
Okay.
And I get dribbles and drabbles on occasion.
So it's just what you do. You like doing it.
I do. I consider it a public service. And actually, I lose money doing it. I spend much more time and energy and gas and camera equipment and computer time doing all of this. So it's not a profitable venture whatsoever.
Why do we still call it taping?
I think it's just the old vernacular. Some people call it filming, taping, video recording. The technology has changed, but the language hasn't.
We find ourselves still doing that. You know, we'll have somebody a disc or somebody to tape.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever. Go ahead.
You had asked me previously if I had posted in advance the event, and yes, I did actually. The day before, I had posted it on my... I believe I posted on my blog. I post on Twitter, on Facebook, and on aboutforsyth.com. Mm-hmm. And so I'll often link between the three different sites. And so the morning of the event, I went to link to the Republican Women of Forsyth County website with the event on it. And it actually wasn't there at 9 o'clock that morning, which was a little curious to me because that was the day of the event. Now, I don't know if the calendar is set to automatically delete events the day of the event, or if for some reason they decided to take it down. But Susan Zerini had posted on Facebook, and that's how I learned about the meeting. And so I was just reposting it again to encourage people to come. And actually, there was quite a big turnout, which they weren't anticipating. And I believe it was because of my post on Facebook and on Twitter that invited a lot of people. And perhaps she might have read my post previously before arriving to that event, and maybe she was expecting me, and maybe she had her mind made up, well, I'm not going to let her record my meeting, I'm in charge. And it almost seems similar to 2 years previously with coming City Hall, where I posted a meeting. It had to do with a water contract between the City of Cumming and Forsyth County. Their 30-year water contract was expiring and they're renegotiating. This was my very first meeting at City Hall. And I posted online so everyone would know about it, because it's of public interest. It's significant to everyone who drinks water, and that's all of us. And so I showed up, and perhaps Mayor knew was expecting me to come that day. I don't know. I had filmed him previously at county meetings in the county administration building and at other debates on SLOS. And so I was familiar to coming to meetings with a camera. But as soon as I came into City Hall, I was ejected. It was like he's in charge, the mayor is the law in coming to City Hall. And I got a similar reaction from Ms. Peggy Green that Susan's not in charge, I'm in charge. This is my meeting. You are not welcome here. And I don't know. I really don't know. It begs the question, I mean, what are you hiding? I don't know the answers to this.
Do you know when they're meeting again?
I assume they have a monthly meeting according to their website, but I don't know their schedule or calendar, and I probably wouldn't go to another one unless there were candidates of particular interest.
Well, and that was my next question. Have you hit most of the meetings?
No, I've only been to one meeting previously, but there are multiple Republican Party groups. And I have been to numerous Republican Party of Forsyth County meetings and filmed them. And they have a debate series. There's another debate, two debates this evening that I'm going to go and record. The chairman, Brad Wilkins, said, "We're glad to have the video." And I've got a recording of him saying that when I raised my hand and announced that this video will be on YouTube. If you have an interest, so most people appreciate the coverage. It's a lot of work, and
I have no doubt it is.
The other media was there at this luncheon meeting, the April luncheon meeting.
Do you remember who?
Aldo Nahed, and he arrived after I did, and Jennifer Sammy. Jennifer Sammy writes for the Forsyth County News.
Mm-hmm.
Aldo Nahed writes for Forsyth Herald.
Okay.
And they're both online, and Aldo did a nice article, and he included links to the video because it was the 2-year anniversary of the incident with the City of Cumming. He has a link to that video as well as a link to the Peggy Green video. Whereas, in contrast, the Forsyth County News didn't mention the incident at all. They just completely ignored it. So there's a lack of balance, I think. So that's why I believe people go to different sources for the news, because you get different stories from different reporters.
And that's true. Even here in town, you've got, or Atlanta, I guess you've got 3 major TV stations. I watch Channel 2. You may watch something else.
I was on Channel 2 last week.
Were you?
Mike Pichetic interviewed me because of this incident. And also, the City of Roswell, I had been to a meeting there on a Saturday. It was a work session. It was advertised as a 7-hour work session from 11 in the morning to 6 at night. And about 5 o'clock, afternoon, they lost a quorum because several city council members had to leave. And at the same time, they decided, all right, we're going to have a staff meeting. The public can stay, but Nydia Tisdale, we don't want you to record the staff meeting. And I wanted to know why. Explain to me why I can't film this. You have public officials here, you're in a public place, you're doing public business, why can't I record? And they said, well, we don't record our staff meetings. And I filed a complaint with the Attorney General last week. And I don't know the yet, they are investigating it, but that was also the subject of the interview on WSB TV.
And going back to that, I wonder, is there a reason that they would have continued the meeting then there instead of just saying, all right, she's not going to follow us, let's just go back to this other office? Why?
And they could have asked the public to leave. They could have closed the meeting and said, okay, we're done with the public meeting. you all have to leave, but, and we, one person did say, do you want us to go? And they said, oh, no, you can stay. You can't have it both ways. You can't be an open meeting with the public there and then say it's closed, you have to turn your camera off. So that was a dichotomy that didn't make any sense.
No, and that kind of is confusing, because if the public could be there, I don't know.
So I'm curious to see what the Attorney General decides on that. But I knew it was not normal. If, I don't think it was proper.
Yeah.
So I'm vocal enough to just speak up and file a complaint. A lot of people will just complain, but not move forward, not do anything further. I have sued the city of Cummings because they grabbed me.
Right.
And actually, I had two armed officers. The chief of police grabbed one arm, and the deputy chief of police grabbed the other arm. Mm-hmm. Someone asked, actually commented on, I believe, an article online saying I should have continued filming the officers at City Hall. And I thought about that, and I realized I didn't have control of my arms because they had me by both arms. That's why I couldn't turn my camera around to film them. Whereas with the city of Roswell, I turned my camera to the city administrator, and I filmed her telling me to turn my camera off. I turned my camera to Peggy Green and filmed her telling me to turn my camera off. But in City Hall, I had my hands on my tripod, and they had their hands on my arms, and I wasn't at liberty to move. And they had guns, and I'm afraid they could arrest me and put me in jail. So I finally acquiesced and turned my camera off.
You know, and I will say this. By that, David George says that if you're being unlawfully arrested, it's your right to resist. But it will probably be more trouble than it's worth before you're exonerated for resisting. So you did the right thing.
Good advice, and thank you for that. It's frightening. It's terrifying when you know you're not doing anything wrong, and you're being physically attacked and verbally attacked, and that's why I filed this incident report, because people need to know that they do have a right to film their public officials in public places and public meetings. And it's just, it's frightening.
$10,000 question. Have you already asked her what you want to happen?
I did through an email about a week ago.
You asked if I wanted to press charges, and I said, yes, I do. I do want to move forward, because your actions have consequences. You can't just ignore it. And I think the public is in an outrage from the comments that I've read online. People are not happy about this. They want some action. I want some action. There are consequences. One other person, since this incident happened, Emily Crabb, has communicated me by email saying that she had a similar incident with Peggy Green, and she wanted to talk to me about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I have not called her yet. I sent her contact information to you via an email.
Mm-hmm.
And she very much would like to speak with someone about what happened. And there were several witnesses. And from what she has emailed me, that there was not a police report, but they were close to calling the police on Peggy Green.
When was that?
From what I'm told, and this is hearsay, I wasn't there, approximately a decade ago. But it was a similar Republican-type meeting, and Peggy Green wasn't happy for whatever reason, and she physically did something. And again, I wasn't there. I don't know. This is what two others reported to me. Grant Meadows has also told me about the incident. Emily Crabb has mentioned the incident. There was another person there, Mike Bussey, who was a witness to the incident. But if you've done this more than once, I think there's a pattern. And I hopefully suggest that you do contact Emily Crabb. I didn't want to affect her testimony in any way, but I think she has some very good information that would be helpful.
It was been 10 years ago, obviously, for misdemeanor. The statute of limitations, that's an issue. But if it's something similar, sure.
For a character witness. Mm-hmm. That it's not the first time she's done this. And that's even more reason to proceed, because what if she does it a third time or a fourth time?
Don't disagree with you. What else can we do for you?
I'm sorry, repeat that?
I'm sorry, I'm slurring my words. I shouldn't have. Need some water. What else can we do for you?
pardon my ignorance, I'm not real familiar with this process. What more do I need to do, if anything, and what can I expect out of all of this? As far as dates or proceedings or hearings or, I mean, just sort of...
Basically, I was assigned the case to basically get all the information that you need. Because obviously it's easier for us to do it than it is for you. All you had was the name tag and that was it. I am going to complete an entire case file just like we do with any investigation. Once it's completed and everything, I will turn all of that information over to you. The way our process is here in Forsyth County and a lot of places is when we have misdemeanor occurrences that aren't family violence, we turn it over to the victim, and you can go to magistrate court and apply for an arrest warrant against her with all this evidence.
Essentially, we did everything for you but apply for the warrant.
Right.
Thank you.
That's me. You will have everything. What we're going to do, we're going to prepare a disc. It's got your incident report. It's got copies of interviews, et cetera, et cetera. It's got everything that we would normally present to the DA's office for a felony arrest if we were doing such. Misdemeanors, we customarily just refer the people back to magistrate court. That's essentially what we're doing here, with the exception that we are doing the legwork and basically the investigation for you. Additionally, it's on video. So there's no...
So you need it if you need it. You know what I mean?
The only... I'll be right back.
But yeah, that's basically, that's usually how processes go. Normally we do an incident report. The officer, whoever's on scene that day, will attempt to get the information of the person involved. For example, Peggy Green, he or she will turn it over to you that day, give you the pamphlet that has the magistrate information on the magistrate court, and he would have done it that day. He either didn't have the capabilities or I don't know if there was a time constraint or whatever. He took the report for you and they forwarded it to us and do it for you, basically.
Okay, it was a little late in the day when I came.
Maybe that's
7:30 on a Thursday. And part of my delay was anticipating perhaps an apology from Ms. Green, and then maybe that might have been the end of it.
Right.
And there was actually a debate that night that I wanted to record, but I didn't because I felt compelled, all right, I need to file this report.
Was she supposed to be at that event also, or?
I don't know if she would have been there or not. There was a chance, yes, and I was a little fearful to go. And I had seen her at other events since. I haven't spoken to her. She was in the hallway, and I took the elevator down to the first floor in the administration building to avoid crossing paths with her, to use the ladies' room, and then I came back up just to avoid her.
Mm-hmm.
There were several, maybe three or four other women, I assume, members of this group, the Republican women,
mm-hmm.
and I don't know their names. Were you able to identify any more meeting attendees that I failed to include in my list? And Peggy Green may be a good person to who else was there besides mm-hmm. herself.
Yeah, and you know, and I talked to Ms. Fisher, and she's, I think, the vice chairman of the whole women's group.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I had her explain everything and what she knew. And, you know, she was shocked that it occurred, too. I mean, she saw the video because, you know, when she came up with the other two ladies, after you explained to her that it or that it was a public, and posted and etc. And just walked away.
Right.
Which, good for her.
She was a kindergarten teacher for 31 years.
Oh, okay.
And actually, she was also the host for a meeting that I filmed last week, having to do a school board bond.
Mm-hmm.
And so she was there, and I recorded her at that meeting, and that was at the administration building. And I was fairly close in part to her, and she said hello, and that was the extent of it, and I said hello, mm-hmm. and then at the end, when she was leaving, by, and that was it, there was no further communication. question at all, but she said a lot. And the other woman, Radzikina, she was also at that event, and she seemed to keep her distance from me. And she was starting to turn her head when she saw my camera.
Yeah, and she has no, she holds no position. She's a fairly new member of that group and was just there and said that she accompanied Peggy basically just for support and what, you know, wasn't aware of the extent and extreme that it was going to become, which I'm sure that was what. But like I said, you know, everybody that was listed, I've talked to. I had her come in, I'm just going to call her Carla. Come in to do a formal interview, and she explained everything. She didn't know a whole lot as far as the meetings and the process and everything because she's just a member. But Ms. Fisher, you know, she explained some of it to me as the vice chairman, and she said that she believed it was, you know, posted on their website, so obviously it's public for anybody to see. And I, you know, the impression got from her was not that she wanted you to leave just for you know, not for the recording, just to not record. But she knew and understood your point as a public event, and she let it go. So that's where we're at with that as far as the actual who hold office. And then, like you told me, I confirmed that Peggy is, I think, the secretary.
Carla, she her badge out of her purse and mm-hmm. put it on mm-hmm. her lapel as she was standing there next to Peggy.
Yeah, she said she had just gotten there probably a couple of minutes before they came up to you. So she was like, I was kind of in the dark as far as what was going on until it transpired.
When Ms. Green said that, when I said it was a public meeting, Carolyn Fisher acquiesced and walked off, and Carla Redzik said that, we can change
that. Yeah.
Or we can change that.
Which I don't know how she'll be able to because, like I said, she doesn't hold a position. But
well, it sounded like we can change the rules as we play the game. It was my interpretation of her statement. But I don't think that's
The only question we really had when all this began was, did Bill Morgan, I'll play because it's his own thing. Did Bill want to tell you to leave or not? And we've since learned no.
No,
so, and of course, that would have no bearing on what we saw in the video, but it would just be something else to consider.
He was busy. He had a restaurant to run, a lot of hungry people to feed. He addressed it because I guess that group comes in frequently, and he didn't want to lose any paying customers, mm-hmm. I'm sure. He was very polite. And actually, that was one of my reasons for leaving when mm-hmm. I did. Because I didn't want to create a bigger scene than there already was.
Right.
And I didn't want to challenge Norman, and he didn't say any of that mm-hmm. to me about leaving his restaurant. And he was polite to me, so I thought, all right, it's time to go.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to win this fight, and I don't want to get hit again, and I don't want my camera to be damaged beyond repair, because I have footage on my camera. I didn't want to lose anything.
Did it hurt?
It hurt my pride. It hurt my feelings. Okay. It hurt my ego as far as physically, I had a pretty thick coat because it was mm-hmm. cold that day.
Mm-hmm. See that?
Padding, yeah. And so there's no bruise to mm-hmm. that effect. But it was highly insulting. It was very mm-hmm. hostile. Yes, I mean it hurt in many ways. But as far as you know, mark on my arm, no, I wouldn't say that. Like a mark on my arm. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. The chairman. The 7th Congressional District Republican Party, Jason Thompson, wrote an apology email to me mm-hmm. after the incident, and someone who's on the executive committee posted on Facebook that he had given the group a directive to shun Peggy Green until she apologizes, which she hasn't done. But a lot of people are not happy with this incident. It was totally uncalled. And I think it puts a bad face on the Republican Party.
Mm-hmm.
And I try to be balanced. No Democrats running in the race, as you know. Some people claim to be Republicans and may or may not be, but it's just, it's embarrassing, I think.
Yeah, it doesn't really look good for anyone. Mm-hmm. So.
I agree. Okay, so we have this in evidence, so you can keep that.
All right.
Like he told you, and I said, you'll basically have another disc just like that, and it'll have the entire case file on it.
Okay. Actually, you mentioned magistrate court. I have filmed in magistrate court previously, and also at the courthouse. I have been there and recorded, and also at the state Supreme Court in downtown Atlanta. I've filmed court proceedings there of particular interest. Actually, I filmed candidate Dwayne Piper when he was running for sheriff. So I'm a pretty familiar face with my camera.
Mm-hmm.
So it's nothing new.
Yeah, I saw once after I had went through the link that you had initially provided, I saw a million of them.
I'm surprised. do you also have a card?
I don't. They have not made me any yet. But you have all of my information still, right? Okay. So if you need it, or if you need me for anything, you know how to contact me. As soon as I get everything completed, I'll contact you and let you know. And if you have anything that comes up or any questions, shoot me an email, give me a call, whichever, and any and all is fine.
Let me ask you both a question. If something like this happened to you, what would your response be?
That's a good question. I don't know. I hadn't really thought about it.
I can see the one of two things happening with me. Probably the one that you did was just leave, just spare everybody the ordeal and just leave, or blow it so far out of proportion that it's not even funny. I tend to be a person, there's a little middle road, that's either one way or the other, but that's just me.
I think, you know, based on your history and having it happen to you multiple times, I probably would be to that point too. You know, maybe if it was a first time incident, but several times at different places, so
mm-hmm.
I can understand that.
Okay. Thank you. Someone who posted a comment that you should have just let her keep hitting and call the police, have a restroom on the spot. I mean, hindsight's 2020.
Right.
When she grabbed the hood of my lens cap and started twisting it, I was afraid she would grab the viewfinder, the little screen next to it, and twist that off. It's a $1,500 camera.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good little tool, and I've got a lot of meetings to record. I don't have time to go replace it. I ordered it from New York and had it shipped.
Right.
I need my equipment.
Expensive, very. Mm-hmm. A friend of mine does photography, and every time she tells me about a new camera, she gets $1,000. So, I understand.
Okay. Anything else?
No.
Okay. Like I said, I'll be contacting you.
I appreciate your time.
I'll walk you out.
Thank you.